In 1784, Westchester was established with the creation of a grid in what is now the heart of downtown Westchester. It was anchored by a courthouse, a school, and a tavern, and several livery stables, and a few farmhouses, and eventually grew into the community that it is today. In 1799, it actually became a borough, the first borough in Chester County. And now it is regarded as a historic community that offers a visitor an opportunity to really get a sense of what it is to see the growth of America from the very beginning. One of the destinations in downtown Westchester is the Chester County Historical Society. Right next door to the Historical Society, and actually part of the Historical Society, is what's referred to as Horticultural Hall. It was built in 1848, and it has a very interesting facade. It's green, it's made of serpentine stone that was quarried just a few miles north of Westchester, and it was designed by Thomas Hugh Walter, America's preeminent architect, who eventually went to Washington, D.C. to complete the expansion of our nation's Capitol building. However, Horticultural Hall stands alone as a great building, so deep and rich in history. It was, for example, the place of the very second women's convention. It was Pennsylvania's first women's rights convention, where they talked about human rights and rights for children and minorities, everyone in the community they felt should deserve to have the same opportunities as everyone else. As you look at the facade, you will see that it has these buttresses on each of the corners that gives it this sense of strength. And you also notice that there is a Romanesque quality to the facade that features a recessed Norman arch right over the door. This incredible building stands as a gateway to the rest of downtown. As you stroll the streets of Westchester, you'll notice historic markers, such as the one on Chestnut Street near Walnut. At that place, there was an old garage called the Pennsylvania Garage that was converted into a laboratory that mass-produced penicillin starting in 1943. This became the first mass production of penicillin in the entire world and was used to aid the war effort during World War II and is credited with saving countless lives as men were able to fix their illnesses and their wounds from infection through the use of penicillin. So we have this little bit of history that spread worldwide, all starting right here in Westchester. The Westchester Armory Building was built in 1916 and is located at 226 North High Street. It was built to serve the National Guard of Pennsylvania Bravo Company, the 1st and 111th Infantry Battalion, and has been serving Pennsylvania since its very inception, started by Benjamin Franklin. This magnificent building is now being repurposed into the Knauer Performing Arts Center, which is showing films and live theater and dance for residents throughout the entire area, bringing in shows from as far away as New York to the enjoyment of the community and visitors alike. On the 100 block of North High Street, we call that the Art Deco block. You'll see the Green Tree building at the corner of Gay and High Street. And across the street, you'll see the Hotel Warner, which originally was built to be the Warner Theater. This magnificent Art Deco building has been repurposed into a hotel and a number of little shops that are front the street of North High Street. And whenever visitors are coming into town, they now have a place where they can sleep. Indeed, the Hotel Warner is the first hotel to have opened in Westchester in over 100 years, and we're delighted to see that they're thriving in downtown. On September 11, 1777, the Battle of Brandywine raged just a few miles south of Westchester. George Washington encountered General Howe of the British forces, and the Revolutionary soldiers lost, and indeed, eventually, Philadelphia fell to the English. During that battle, there were skirmishes throughout the area, and Westchester was used as a field hospital. There was a school on the corner of what is now Gay and High Street, and that school was converted into a field hospital where soldiers were taken, most of whom died. Indeed, they say that there are a number of graves still below the streets in downtown Westchester of both Revolutionary and English soldiers. There's a building called the Insurance Building located at 15 East Gay Street. That building is notable for being a Beaux-Arts example of architecture, and it's right next door to a Brutalist style architecture building, very complementary to each other, demonstrating that there is a wide range of architectural styles here in downtown Westchester. The United States Post Office is a historic building located at the corner of East Gay Street and Walnut Street. It was built in 1907 and expanded in 1935. It's notable for being faced with a stone called Cockeysville marble, which was quarried about 18 miles away from Westchester in the Avondale Quarry. Cockeysville marble has this crystalline quality. It glitters in the sunlight. But the stone is most famous for being the stone that was used on the Washington Monument in Washington, D.C. So we have a little bit of a connection with some of the greater buildings of our country. On North High Street between Market and Gay Street is a row of very historic buildings. Perhaps the grandest of those is the First Bank of Chester County, built in 1837, and while it's had a number of names throughout the decades, it remains the oldest structure that is still continuing for the purpose of which it was built, that to be a bank. It was designed by Thomas U. Walter, who eventually went to Washington, D.C. to complete the expansion of the nation's Capitol building. This building, the First Bank of Chester County, helped give Westchester the nickname of the Athens of Pennsylvania. And indeed, with the columns, you feel like you're in a little bit of Greece as you walk down the sidewalks of North High Street. The oldest building in downtown Westchester is the William Darlington Building. It's located at 13 North High Street and was constructed in 1789. Indeed, it is the oldest surviving first period structure in downtown. William Darlington is considered to be the father of Westchester. He not only worked at this building, he also lived in this building. And it gives you an idea of how great minds were able to get together within proximity of each other to help develop the community of Westchester into what it is today. The stone relief sculpture is located at 10 North High Street as part of an international style building that was built in 1966. The stone relief itself was created by sculptor Harry Rosen, a Bucks County sculptor who was commissioned by the county commissioners to depict a number of characters associated with Chester County that include George Washington and the Marquis de Lafayette. This is a magnificent example of public art, and perhaps one of the best of the examples of public art to be found in Southeast Pennsylvania. The most magnificent of the historic buildings in downtown Westchester is the historic Chester County Courthouse, located on the corner of High and Market Streets. It sports a clock tower that has been chiming its bell since 1838, as a matter of fact, and has kept time on the hour every hour, and it has become the oldest sound in Westchester. The building itself was designed by Thomas Hugh Walter and is one of his most magnificent structures. Thomas Hugh Walter, of course, is noted for being the architect of the expansion of our nation's capital. But beyond that, there are a handful of structures, such as the historic courthouse, that really tell a story of the magnificence that we thought of when we developed our government system here in Chester County. If it wasn't for the county seat of Chester County, Westchester probably would not have a reason to exist. And so we are most happy to have the cornerstone of our community located there. The Buckwater Building is located at 11 South High Street. It's very interesting in that it's one of the few buildings that truly has imported stone from far away. Indeed, the English redstone and iron spotted Pompeian brick give it a unique quality, sometimes called brownstone. The asymmetrical architectural features of the Buckwater Building make it one of the most curious buildings that you'll see in the downtown. The largest and tallest commercial structure of a historic nature here in downtown Westchester is at the F&M Building, Farmers and Mechanics Building. It's located on the corner of Market and High Street, and it was completed in 1908. It's a Beaux-Arts style building and is considered to be Westchester's first and only skyscraper. That is, it was built from the inside out. Today, it is clearly a landmark type of building for downtown that shows how strong the commercial era was at the beginning of the 20th century. In 1833, there was a building built considered to be part of the second period of growth for Westchester, and that building is now known as the Lincoln Building. It's located on Market Street at Wilmot Mews, and it's called the Lincoln Building because Abraham Lincoln's very first biography was written and published there on February 11, 1860. This biography helped launch Lincoln's candidacy to become President of the United States. The building itself is in pristine shape, and visitors can visit anytime on the weekdays during normal business hours. And if you do so, you'll see a building as it stood over 150 years ago, and the artifacts from the biography and autobiography of Abraham Lincoln are on display at that area. What did family businesses look like in the early 1800s? You can certainly find out by visiting Peter and Mary Rush's grocery store, or at least the building that had the grocery store, on the corner of Market and Church Street. This structure has a canopy that wraps around the building, once a common feature for several of the structures. Now only a handful exist in Westchester. The family worked there at their grocery store probably 12 hours a day, 7 days a week, and it was a gathering place for folks to come into the community, pick up something to eat, learn what the gossip was, and enjoy all of the amenities that Westchester had to offer. In 1799, the first Westchester Fire Company was created to be a bucket brigade. But by 1888, they needed a new building, and T. Ronan Williamson built a Queen Anne style station for them with very unique features. There's a tower on it that is used to dry wet hoses as well as to spot fires from anywhere in the greater Westchester area. And it also had barracks for firemen and a place to hang out. But of course, anytime a fire broke out, they were up and ready to meet the challenge any time of day or night. Today, it is a restaurant, so you can go to it and enjoy the amenities while you're enjoying this unique architectural building in downtown.